Example 5.4. A quarry outside of Austin wishes to evaluate two similar pieces of equipment by which the company can meet new state environmental requirements for dust emissions. The minimum attractive rate of return is 12% per year. Determine which alternative is economically better using A, the annual worth method, and B, the annual worth method, but with a 3-year study period. Okay, so then we have our two alternatives here. And just a friendly reminder, if you are evaluating multiple alternatives, the process is going to be very similar to what we covered in Chapter 4 for present worth. But in this case, you're going to convert everything to annual, and then you're going to compare the individual results, and you're going to pick the numerically largest one, which is the value that it's going to cost you the least per year. So we go back, we analyze our numbers here, and we find that we have a first cost for both of them. So this would be letter P. We have an annual operating cost. It doesn't mention that it changes anywhere in the timeline. So it's going to be uniform. That's your A. You have the life in years. Just remember from the first section that for annual worth, you do not need LCM if you have different lives. So you will be comparing these alternatives over their respective lives. So it's going to be n equal to 4 for alternative X and n equal to 6 for alternative Y. Then we have the salvage value, which is your F. There's another value here, the estimated value after 3 years. We're going to come back to this one in a bit because that one refers to Part B. Because for Part B, we're going to be using a study period. So yes, we can still evaluate the alternatives over a study period if we want to. But if they just ask for the annual worth method without giving you a study period, just know that you do not need the LCM. Okay. So for now, let's focus on this part of the information and let's solve for Part A. First of all, let me draw the diagrams for both pieces of equipment. So let me write down equipment X . Okay, so for equipment X I only need 4 years. It's gonna be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. We have P, so it's 40,000. Going down because it's a cost, even though they don't actually add the negative signs here, you know, if it's a cost, it goes down. You have your annual operating cost also going down. $25,000. And then your salvage value at the end of the life, it's going to be $10,000. And well, this is going to be based on a minimum attractive rate of return of 12% per year. Then I have equipment Y. For this one, I'm going to need 6 years. Zero, one, two, three, four, five, six. Same thing, you have a P going down. This is for 75,000. You have your annuals that are uniform. 15,000. And your salvage value at the end of the sixth year, which is going to be 7,000. Okay. So based on this, let's solve part A. So this part A, it's going to be the annual worth. So it just says the annual worth analysis, but know that it's going to be the annual worth over the respective lives. And you only use one life cycle. No need for LCM and repeating cycles. So let's calculate the annual worth of machine X. Okay, so let's go with the first part. We need to convert the P. So it's going to be minus 40,000. Find a given P at 12%, and this is only for 4 years. Okay. Then we have the annual, it's already in A, minus 25,000. And then we add the salvage, 10,000, convert it to A, find A given F at 12%, and we also want it over 4 years. Okay, so if you're to calculate all of your factors and multiply, add, subtract, you would get minus 36,077 dollars per year. Okay, so just wanna point out that you used a 4 here and a 4 over there. Okay, so I have my first answer. Now, let's calculate, do the same, follow the same process. So we calculate the annual worth for alternative Y. So it's going to be minus 75,000 for the present. Find a given P, 12%, but pay attention to this because it's going to be for 6 years. Your AOC doesn't change, so you just add it, or in this case, subtract it here. Minus 15,000 plus the salvage value, 7,000. Find A given F at 12%, and this is also for 6 years. Okay, so you will end up getting minus $32,380 per year. Just to point out, the ends will be different. Let me highlight my second result. Okay, so now it's time to pick one from these two, and the numeric, they're both negative, but the numerical largest one, or the least negative, the least cost would be the annual worth of Y. So this right here is the best alternative. So we're done with part A. Now let's go back to the instructions. Part B, annual worth method with a 3-year study period. So now, in this case, for part B, the N will be 3 for both of them. So both of them will be using an N of 3. And this is where we're going to use our estimated value after 3 years. Because remember that, and I'm going to recycle the diagrams that we have here. Remember that, well, just a note here, note that this, we used it for alternative A. So I'm going to write on top of this. So for the study period, I only need these 3 years. So I'm just going to consider, well, the P and the annual for 3 years, and we're going to ignore the rest. So that means that in year 3, I need to have another salvage value. But they're giving it to me. So this is the one that I'm going to be using. Okay, for part B. So for part B, I'm going to be using a salvage of 14K. $100K for this part. And then for equipment-wise, I'm also only taking into consideration 3 years and I'm ignoring the rest. So in year three, I need to have my salvage value and it's going to be 20,000. Okay, so remember for part B, I am only using these three and these three over here. Okay, so now let's change the color. Part B, it's going to be a 3 year study period. Okay, so annual worth of X, same formula, minus 40,000. We still want to convert it to A. Find A given P at 12%, but remember that we're only using 3 years, so we put a 3 here. Minus 25,000 plus a salvage. Find A given F 12%, and I also only want 3 years. Okay, so my answer for this will be minus 37,505 dollars per year. Okay, so just the note here to highlight that we are using a 3 on both of them. And then our second one, the annual worth of Y, same process, minus 75,000. Find A given P 12%, and this is also for 3 years, minus the uniform A plus the salvage value. Find A given F 12%, and will also be 3. For this one, you will get minus 40,299 dollars per year. Again, let me highlight that there's a 3 here, a 3 here, and they both match the study period. So I have another answer here, and you must pick one from the two. And for the 3 year study period, it turns out that alternative X would be the best alternative.